Floor pan is a compacted layer of soil profile, usually found at a depth of 25 to 30 cm, with a thickness of up to 15 cm. The plow pan does not form in a single year, but is the result of repeated cultivation errors and multiple plowing. Subsoiling is an effective method for removing compacted layers in the soil and restoring it to its original state, desired by the agricultural producer. The subsoiler is a fairly simple agricultural machine with working elements in the form of tines ending in chisels. The chisel elements reach deep into the soil, disturbing even parts that were not affected by plowing. Subsoiling involves dragging the tines submerged at a depth of 40 to 60 cm through the soil. The result is the breaking of hard layers of soil around the passage of the chisel without turning it over. Breaking the hard layer of soil improves the ability to quickly take in rainwater to store it in the soil and ensures easier plant survival during drought periods. The factors determining the need to use a subsoiler should be waterlogging in spring or during rains and the inability to work to the appropriate depth with cultivation machines. However, this procedure is best performed after the harvest when the soil is dry. It is usually recommended that subsoiling be performed every 3-4 years. Generally, it is worth loosening the soil 10 to 15 cm below the deepest cultivation depth. Subsoiling tools offered by Rolmako include Universal Subsoiler U602, Subsoiler with a Coupler U608, Subsoiler U614, Subsoiler U619, Multipurpose Subsoiler U638, Subsoiler with a Coupler and Atlas Tine U632, Subsoiler U626 Storm, Chisel Plow U624. The chisel plow is a device that provides savings by using one tool instead of several others. It is used for breaking and aerating the soil for deep loosening of the subsoil to improve its structure. Such a procedure can fully eliminate traditional plowing. Using a spiked roller with chisel plow can prepare the field directly for sowing. Rolmako subsoilers mainly differ in the type of tines and their arrangement on the frame. The process of soil loosening depends on the shape of the tine. The chisel mounted on the straight tine of the U602 subsoiler is extended forward to allow the tine to penetrate well, and the tine can pass more easily through the loosened layer of soil without mixing it. Soil loosening with a working element with a tine curved to the side, so-called Michel system, used in Rolmako subsoilers U608, U614 and U619, has a completely different character. In this case, the chisel is narrow and the soil is lifted primarily by the lower part of the tine, which is curved to the side, which increases the soil loosening zone. Such tines do not tend to pull stones out. In a classic subsoiler, the tines are arranged in a single row. However, the special V-shaped frame of the U614 subsoiler allows for work with even less power requirement. Subsoilers with tines arranged on two beams are gaining more and more popularity. The two-row design allows for more intensive work to achieve an even better effect of breaking excessively compacted lower soil layers. The Atlas tines of the U638 and U632 subsoilers are characterized by the highest wear resistance, which is possible due to the use of the best materials, such as cemented carbide. The ripper tine of the U624 chisel plow has a special design, which allows for smooth, gradual penetration of the soil structure. Side cutters allow for a wider opening of the trench, which enhances the effect of water infiltration. Additionally, the tine is equipped with a central cutter in the shape of a shark fin, which allows easier penetration of the soil's upper layer and reduces resistance posed by the tine shank while simultaneously protecting it. A simple shear screw protection can be replaced depending on the model with a non-stop spring or hydraulic protection. The spring protection is a mechanical safeguard that protects the machine with a double spring. When the tine hits a stone, it tilts along with the shank, compressing the spring. After overcoming the obstacle, the tine automatically returns to the working position. The hydraulic overload system of the subsoiler ensures precise work, easy operation and high efficiency. In the version with hydraulic protection, each tine of the subsoiler is equipped with a cylinder. The cylinders are connected by hoses to an accumulator, which is responsible for maintaining a specified tilting force of the tine before the obstacle. When the subsoiler encounters a stone, hydraulic oil flows into the tank. This closes the cylinder, which returns to the working position after passing the obstacle. Rolmako subsoilers are increasingly ordered in combination with additional soil finishing tools behind the tines. These are most often various types of rollers, such as the twin disc roller or the double spike roller, which, in addition to finishing the soil, also set the depth of the tines. Subsoiling can be used in both plowed and no-plow farming systems as an additional intervention measure, and it is necessary where the soil is excessively compacted. With an aggregate based on the subsoiler, such as a subsoiler combined with a disc harrow, deep no-plow cultivation can be achieved, replacing traditional plowing, where the depth of cultivation can be varied, deepening it in more compact areas. Rolmako offers innovative machines with great adaptability to customer requirements and proven models that successfully cultivate soil from Africa to Australia. In the catalog at rolmako.com/technical, you will find transport dimensions, dimensions of working elements, and distances between them, everything you need to know when looking for a machine. Rolmako is not just a manufacturer of agricultural equipment, but also a partner who thoroughly understands farmers' needs. Thanks to its flexibility and reliability, it is a dependable choice that brings success in farming from Africa to Australia. The technical catalog is a comprehensive source of information that makes it easier to make the best choice of cultivation machine.